What's up, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to City Skylines. My name is DivaRix, of course, and today we're gonna be working on the suburban areas. That's been requested by someone, so I figured let's do it. And as you might be able to see right now, we're having some cinematic shots. And this is the first time I've ever tried it, so bear with me. I hope you like what you're seeing right now. That's the downtown, and in a minute it's gonna end. There it is. That was the cinematic of the downtown area. And I'm just gonna be trying something out with that, and I hope to can that I'm able to do a lot more of these cinematic shots and have music there and make it look cool and epic. But I want to work on the suburban area, which is gonna be here. The first one is gonna be here at least, and we're gonna make many more around here. This island is gonna be suburban probably. But we did in previous episodes, the previous two episodes, we worked on this area. This is the racetrack, as you might be able to see right here. I think this looks really cool. I love it. We got some commercial signs and whatever, and I like how it looks. It's still far from finished, actually. We have done some detail work in the previous episode, like for example this right here, and something like this, and something I gotta finish probably off screen. I'm not gonna bother too much with doing the detail on the racetrack on screen. I might do another detail work in episode, but that's gonna be one big speed up. Anyways, we're gonna get started on the suburban area, and I got some cool roads for that, so we're gonna definitely use them all. And as you can see, we got some bushes in the middle of the boulevard here. This is gonna be the center road probably for this area, so we're gonna focus on that a bit. And I think we're gonna make a road which follows like the coastline. I think that will look cool, so let's try something like that. Maybe to about this extent right here. And we're gonna go into like the bendy shapes. I don't know. I don't like it so far, so let's get rid of this part as well. And let's grab this this road right here. And this suburban area is gonna be grid pattern, so this is not the most expensive area you can live in, but it's gonna be just some grid. And I think that will work. It has to do, because we do need some people living in the city. We only have 27,000 in a city like this, so we can make that many, many more. Now let's do something like that. Do we want some trees in the middle? Because that might look awesome, actually. Let's just get this out of the way, and let's say we want one tile in the middle. Then we can always have some room for trees and bushes if we ever want to detail it a bit more. And this is going to be a very straightforward area, this, and probably near the sea it's going to be a bit more expensive, and the houses will have a bit larger garden and it looks a bit nicer and all. This is just to pack a lot of people in one area. That's going to be this. Alright, that works. Looks like these areas are a bit smaller in between, but they're probably not. Oh, they're perfect. Alright, so let's get some of these houses in, because we do want... Wait a second. If we go like 3 or something... I'm gonna go 30 out and then connect up again. No, that's something I gotta do in the future. Let's first zone this area, because that is the most important thing so far. Doesn't have to be perfect, just has to be zoned. Because I wanna use the theme manager for this district. And I got a couple cool houses. I got the some American style homes, so that's definitely something I wanna use in the city. And we are gonna use them, so let's set the policies and the themes, and allow theme manager for this district, get the American houses, and I think Yeah, look, we got some American houses, which is cool. I think they will start living there. The policies, do we need anything else? Let's check real quick. That's something we can always do. And then let's grab some of this. It's gonna be 4. This is just to measure out how much houses I want in this area. It's gonna be 7. Let's say 8. What am I doing? That's 6. Why am I thinking it's 8? So 6. Yeah, that's gonna be working very well. And then grab the road, which goes here. And then I misplaced something right there. Cool. And that is how many tiles. That is the question of the day, how many tiles it is. So we can... It's 35. Why can't I do 35? Neither, 37, 36. And it goes to 34, so that's probably 35. Let's check real quick, that's 35, that's good. That means we can have some houses here. And why don't you, oh, it's, the game is paused, that's what's wrong. I want people to start building in this area. This has to be like a very nice neighborhood. There's lots of schools and, you know, it's pretty nice. It's green. I'm trying to make it look very nice as well, so. So the first houses are being built. Let's just quickly check what they're making. Excuse me. These are probably level 1 houses. And they're probably all the same. Which they are. I think we only have 1 level 1 house, which is, it's quite terrible. Let's go there really quick to the American house. Oh, wait. Theme manager. There's level 1. So yeah, there's only 1 level 1 house, and it's the American Dream. Which is kind of bad. I should have downloaded more level 1 houses, but that's okay. We're just gonna let these people build their houses and do whatever they want in here. And then we should be okay. Let's get like a pipeline there. Beautiful, so they got almost, they almost have a water connection. Beautiful, and that means they also need some power. What is this? It's a construction crane. Let's get to the power and then we're gonna probably use these ones. But that is zoned too, so I want them to build that real quick. And then get the power situation good and going. Like so. That's nice. And then I hope to get some more people there in that area. So they get power. Look at all these houses, they're exactly the same. That's gonna look really bad now. But I think in the future, we're gonna have like... lots of different houses there. It's just gonna take some time to build up, actually. But I don't think that's a big deal. This works for now, so it's good. It's good. Life's good. And this again has to be 35, probably. It's gonna be 35 right there. I don't know. This is a difficult question. It's 35... into that one, so let me just... How many tiles is that in between there? That's 2 and that's 1, so it's probably 30, 2 or something. I really have no idea. I'm just gonna try something out right now, and then we're gonna see how that turns out. So that's 32. That should be 35. No, that's 34. Right there. That's gonna be 35. And if it isn't... 35. Look at me. Professional road builder. So I think we have enough houses. Yeah, yeah, stop complaining. You build there and then everything is fixed. So I think it's gonna be quite a large or nice neighborhood, and quite large as well. It's gonna be like this whole section of the map. I don't think we even have any level 2 houses here. So they do need electricity, and they're gonna get electricity. Have it, have some now. Alright, so they're also gonna need a couple like these things. A hospital, outside connection to the road. That's also something we gotta fix really soon, but what's that? What does that mean? I guess they look cool, the houses. I don't know, really. They're all exactly the same, which is kind of weird, actually. I've never seen, like, a neighborhood with those houses. I think there are in some neighborhoods in the Americas which have all the same houses. But I don't know if it's like a wealthy neighborhood then or not so wealthy. I really have no idea. So what I'm gonna do right here is I'm gonna expand this one. And then there's gonna be like a main road, because we do need traffic to go into different directions, of course. And that means we have like 5 of these blocks next to each other with a main road separating them, which is good. I think we can do 5 more or something. And then let's get 5 in there. 3. Whoops. It's 4. And then we gotta get to the main road again, which is this one. And that means we have 5 in there and 5 in there, which is good. Fits exactly. And then continue these roads all the way down there. That is my phone. I am very sorry. That is some... I'm sorry, I was distracted by my phone. Pipeline problems? Nope. Okay, cool. That works. And then connect these up. This neighborhood is gonna be very green looking, I believe. And then I think here we're gonna have some more expensive houses or something. They have like a nice large garden and you know, whatever. They're gonna look cool. Look at all the same houses from a distance, looks so weird. I do want them to level up actually, so let's check why they're not... No level up info available. No one lives there. Oh, it is probably because they don't have an outside road connection. So, we're probably gonna make an interchange. And I don't know what kind of interchange is suitable for that location. This one still looks so bad. It's still very busy here. Oh, by the way, the black planes and black cars problem still hasn't been fixed. I was too lazy to really look into it. Sorry. But I will. I will look into it very soon. But what kind of interchange do these people need? Now, for now, I think we can make do with a That's the wrong thing. I'm gonna guess this will work as well. So at least now they have a road connection. It's gonna divert a lot of traffic from that area to here. So we're gonna make an interchange. Might be there or here. And then have it go off into the neighborhood from this direction. And maybe we're gonna need two. I don't know how the traffic is gonna be in an area like this. It's probably gonna be very expensive. Expensive or very busy. So that's something we gotta figure out in the future. But yeah, let's see. I like how it looks so far. Let's check the nighttime really in the city, because that's something we haven't done in a long time. So that's nighttime. Neighborhood looks fancy. Looks good. How does downtown look? Downtown looks really cool. It's nicely lit up. We got these buildings light up at night. This one and the other ones. This is very blue there. Shame the like the most tall building doesn't light up. Except these lights above there. But I really would have liked it to light it up. It would be cool. And I think the racetrack is still very, very dark. Except for those signs, they emit light as well, so that's kind of cool, actually. You can really follow the track if you're here at night. You know where to go. Almost. I've got a couple lights in there, and I think the pit lane. Yeah, this is also lit up. Cool. And that's emitting a lot of light here. I likey. And let's continue with this area. That's what the goal was today, to finish a neighborhood. So let's focus on that. So we're gonna make 35 out of this. I believe that is 35. That is 36, which means I've messed up again. And why is this system not... Oh my god, I think I do have a system which will work. There's probably gonna be 36 again. There. If this doesn't work... 35, good. Good. Connect these up as well. And then just continue the grid pattern along the way. Now these same houses look so different than what I expect from this game. And houses starting to grow here which weren't the district theme. But that doesn't matter. That doesn't matter at all. Now I'm hoping that they will improve, and that means increase the value of land. And it's probably they need hospital, they need a fire station, they need police coverage and whatever, they all need that. So I think what's good to do is to like dedicate like two of these blocks with a school, a high school, like a school compound, and you know, a police station, which I still have to download some nice texture models for police station. I do have a bit of a different one, but I don't think, well, this one looks a bit nice, but still not really the ones I would like to use. For schools, I got a couple cool models, which I want to use, so let's just do that and dedicate a little space to school and whatever. So it's gonna be this, and then we're gonna need the high school, like right there. I'm gonna use this high school for this neighborhood. I think that's a good high school. Looks pretty nice, looks decent. And then we're gonna also need an elementary school, which this is elementary school, but this is one too. But we already used this one in a more classic location, so I should get an elementary school right at the corner here. And then what do we have more? So we got high school. And if you want to go to college and university, you got to go to the main city, because there is no university in a neighborhood like this. It really isn't. That's the truth. So so that's that. And well, we might do like the bus station for this area also in this. Like, this is a very nice central point. You got this road coming in here, which is gonna change a bit up, but that's okay. So let's do our very own bus station design or something. Let's check how the model is on here. So they use the one-ways, these tiny roads, and I think we're gonna use them here as well. So let's just shape that up. And that means the bus goes in there. Doesn't even have to be that long, it's just gotta be tiny space for the buses to park in. Something like this maybe. So let's say there are four bus lines stopping here. I think that's pretty decent. Yeah, that's okay, and then have a subway station and all that kind of stuff there for public transport. That will work. We don't need like huge public transportation here and all, and yeah, this is a bit bad looking. I know that, I can see that. So that's probably something that has to be fixed up, and let's do that something by creating a road which goes like right here next to the two schools. And you may change location. Not enough water. Then go away. You gotta respect my authority. Okay, so it needs one more tile there. So let's just change that road to about there. And then we have that location fixed as well. And then we're gonna need you to go like right there, maybe. Or still at the corner. Let's have you here. That can be a nice location. And let's detail up the schoolyard. I think we can make it look... This area of the map, I'm pointing at my screen right now, which you are not able to see. I think we can make that look a bit nicer by like changing it up and doing a bit of park stuff there, which can be cool. So let's grab the concrete fillers and just make a little shape there. Like a nice open place where these guys can chill out and hang out and do whatever they want. Just like that, very nice. Then have the yeah, this can continue as well. And I believe if we go to the props and then go to like the painting, where was that? I think it's this one. And we go here. Press Shift P. There is a basketball court. which I think we are able to use quite nicely in here. Just line it up there. Beautiful. So let's say we have two basketball courts for the school, which will work very nice. And then that place is detailed up. We also have more of these things right here. And let's grab the prop line tool and then go to the options and allow prop anarchy on. Okay, cool. Get rid of you again. That should be the middle, like centered. I don't know why it doesn't like line them up perfectly. Kind of gets on my nerves sometimes, but there is really nothing I can do to change that. So that's something I gotta live with. You know, that's my life for today. Let's just do the same on this side. You know, it doesn't have to be functional. It just has to look nice, and that's what I'm trying to do here. I'm trying to make it look cool. So I got one more little idea here, and that's gonna be like the 1x4. It's gonna be nice in the center. That's about it. And I got the prop tool again. You go there and there. So we got a nice little opening there to go into that area and do whatever. Now we go to the trees, and then let's see what kind of tree we're gonna use here. Now I'm thinking that's a bit of a sad tree for a school. That's a bit of a scary tree for a school. This might be looking very nice. I'm gonna need a couple large trees in there, just to make it look that tad nice. And then we have like this little tree, or that one. Of course, there is no detail working episode without the London Plane Tree. That's a nice one. So it doesn't like have to be filled up with trees and all, but just has to make or look a bit nicer. And you can always have one of or a couple of these guys in there as well. Like a couple of these trees, I think they look nice, so why not use them? Now might be my chance to use these. Disconnect the power grids. I don't really care. You shouldn't either, game. That's my cup of tea. Not my cup of tea, but that's something I should take care of, which I'm not doing like a mayor should do. So, which probably means I'm a bad... That's what I still am forgetting to this date. The mayor's house. So somewhere in this very nice neighborhood, might be here, like at the corner, there's gonna be like this huge mansion where the mayor of the city is able to live or will live. Oh, look at this. This looks so much nicer than what it was before. I like this a lot. So let's just fix it up with detail really quick. Let's get the fence there, which is not that one. That's the gate. Now in the previous episode, I asked you if you like these detail things, and you did. You really liked them. So we're gonna do more of them like I'm doing now. We're gonna do these little things. I enjoy them as well. I don't know why, but as long as it's not a large project, which takes me 30 minutes like a large project, this will only take me maximum of 10. And I like if it's not taking too long, because I have a very short attention span. Probably the attention span of a 12-year-old, like said before. And yeah. That's why I don't like doing like these lot of detail work in episodes and making just 100,000 time lapses in one, because I don't have the attention span for it. I don't want to edit all that. I mean, I like editing, but I really don't want to edit all of those things I do not really enjoy making. So that's why I don't want to edit them. And how did they do it? Probably something like this. Just a very simple shape. Look at the school. People are running. So there's more seating possibilities in the backyard of the school than in my entire school, which is good. Now they might need fences around it, but I don't think they do. Let's get some real picnic tables in there. Looks real American like this. Right, that looks like a school. It really does. In my opinion, this looks like a school with a nice playground, with some trees, with some greenery. Awesome, epic, I like it. Now there's even room for some trees here, which I'm not gonna bother with yet. If the neighborhood looks not so green, then I will bother with them. And now let's check on the houses. Are there any different houses yet? I do not believe so. And that is because these people are needing more land value. Now these are probably the first people to upgrade. Educate more citizens. Yeah, yeah. So they are able to go there. And here is the place where the bus will stop. So we can have some parks in there. But that's something we got to do once the metro stations and the buses will drive. And we can have or create a nice little park area there. And it's going to be trees. But that's going to be the detail working stuff for probably next episode. Because I don't think we're going to be able to finish the detail working episode on this. And in just everything. But close by this neighborhood, which has a tremendous house fire, we're also gonna need shops. So I think about doing like a shopping street here, like a market street. And I have like this beautiful street where I'm probably gonna ban cars because I have a mod installed which called Traffic President, and you can like do some traffic things. And I want no cars there and only people walking, so we can create some epic stuff with that. And I really want to do that, so that's something I gotta do. Now this is the only thing I hate, people parking on the side of the road, but I guess there's nothing we can do about it really. And we need a name for this district. So if you are a loyal subscriber, leave a comment below that you want this name, this district named after you. And then we will. But this is going to be called The Burbs for now. The Burbs. That's the microphone. If you, I'm trying to type, but the microphone is literally on the keyboard, so you can type. So The Burbs is there. And if you're a cool guy, or a girl, of course, that's also allowed. Then, and you're epic, and you're on the channel a lot. You, we might name something after you. Now, for the city, I don't know how long I'm gonna continue this. I'm gonna talk, for about 2 minutes now, and then we're gonna continue with this work. But, the city, I like it. I like it a lot. And, you know, we've been here for 20 episodes. This is the 20th episode, and we've done a lot. We've done little projects like the stadium, like the airport, like the projects, the poor people area, like the train station, the university, the downtown office areas. We did multiple episodes of that, the racetrack, and now the suburbs, the hotel resort area. We did a lot. We really did a lot. And I don't want to quit with this series, but if I always look at the other YouTubers series, they always have these very green looking maps with this nice color green, and then I look to my map and then it has this weird looking dark green grayish color, which I hate. And that's something I should have noticed when I started working on the city, but I didn't for some reason. So that's why we're stuck with it now, and I don't know how long I'm gonna continue with this series, but as it's looking right now, the game runs very smooth, very perfect, doesn't crash no more. I'm still gonna be continuing with this series for I think a bit more time. If we have like the suburbs running and we got suburbs here and the downtown finally looks nice instead of this crappy old thing right here, which no one really wants to look at and I don't too, so let's get rid of it. Not now, but later. And if we get that all fixed and the city looks nice, I think I'm gonna quit the series. I'm not gonna improve anything, but we're gonna start over for season 3 and then we're gonna like make it happen from the first episode. So we're gonna do lots of detail working like we did in here. We're gonna have like cool buildings and cool suburban areas like we have here, with a nice downtown like there, and just all these kind of stuff which I have now and always has a nice tight area, or tiny area, not tight, tight something else, a tiny area. But this city doesn't feel like one. It has all these little pieces here and there. We got the downtown, then we got this part of the city which no one really knows what it is. Then we got the stadium, that's usually a separate part, and that's good. And we got the racetrack there. It just doesn't, it's not connected. Literally, it's not connected. But for my liking, it isn't connected as well. It's not one whole as a city. It's just three separate things next to each other. And that's something I really want to improve on, but I really have no idea how to. So if you have any tips and tricks for me, then please, please let me know. I really want to know what I can improve on my cities and what is already perfect. So if you're still watching to this point, which I highly doubt, please leave in the comments what I can improve. and what you would like to see me improve on, and what you think is already perfect. That's you can leave that out. I don't know. Just tell me what I can improve, and I'll try and look into that. Thank you in advance. I'm sounding like a professional right now. Let's get back into the building, because we still have to do a lot, and I'm more always talkative. I don't know. In real life, I'm not so much, really. I am a bit, but on here, once I start talking, there is no stopping me. And that can be quite annoying sometimes for you and for me as well. Because then I'm editing the video and I'm like listening, and why won't this guy shut up for once? For 1 second, why can't he shut up? I don't know. That's my experience from my YouTube career. My YouTube career with 450 subscribers. That's also something. We almost got 450 subscribers. That's actually insane for me. I never expected to hit that number. I really didn't. You know, I was always like, I'm always hoping for more. And I guess that's what you do in real life. You always like hope, oh, one day I might have 1 million subscribers. But then you like come back to reality and it's like, nah, that's not happening. It's not happening. Not in 1 million years. Because there's already so much YouTubers to choose from. So why would they choose me? That's what I'm always thinking. Once I think from, well, maybe I could get more views on YouTube, and then always that thought is right after, like, why would they choose me over the others? They make such or more better videos than I do, and then they can speak English and I can't. You know, it's that little, those little things that that really, like, I don't know, confuse me sometimes. That's the word, I believe. Confuse me. I hope you know what I mean. It makes sense for me. I don't know if it does for you, but it is what it is, people. It is what it is. You know, I really like this area. I really do. I don't know why, but it just looks cool. So, yeah. These people, man. There's all the same house. There's probably 100 of these houses right here. So the guy who designed... Why are you mad like that, bro? Your neighbor's happy, and your other neighbor's really happy. So why are you mad, huh? Hey, look at this. That's for being ignorant. And these people are complaining about crime. I can understand that, but that's something that's gonna be taken care of in the future, sir. So don't you worry about it. And I really like how the neighborhoods look. How the neighborhood looks. There's only one pretty large problem, and that is trees. There's no tree at all. Now I hope if they upgrade to a bigger house, why won't... Okay, so no level up. Oh, wait, here we go. So to educate more citizens, and why is that so? That's because no one goes to the high school. All of you people. You know, I think it's time for one. But if I just delete one piece of road, then it will be all messed up. That's why I'm not making bus routes. And I think I should make temporary bus routes. So let's just do one. Alright, let's just do one simple bus route, which is only in this area and doesn't go to the main city. So you go and you stop there, and you go there, and you go there, and you go there, there, and you stop there as well. Why you would do that, I have no idea, but you go ahead, you do that. That only takes more time, and you stop like at every block, and then you come back around. Stop there, and there, stop there, there, and there, and you stop right at the school, like right there, and you come back around and stop there. That will work. So let's pause the game, and let's remove every vehicle that is in there. Yeah, like that, remove you, and remove you, remove all these vehicles, and then we're gonna add select types at first. And I think I'm gonna go for the citywide LF. Probably that's the smallest one. I have no idea. And we're gonna add, what is it? We got stops 18, so we're gonna add 9 buses. Alright, that makes sense. That's logic. That's logic, right? So they all have to come from all the way up here. It's probably them leaving right now. No, it's not. That's the Scania bus. So that bus will be driving in this neighborhood. Is that a house upgrading, or is that just a new one being built? That's a new one being built. Damn it. I would like to see new houses in here. Yeah. Okay, so I don't know what to do now. I just gotta wait until these houses upgrade and, you know, more stuff happens. Let's just go for, it's all gonna be the same neighborhood. It's all gonna be the burbs. Like so. Let's create a bit of a, like a nice shape of areas, which is gonna be like in this block. This is gonna be for the richer people. They also need a place to live. Come with me if you want to live. My Arnold Schwarzenegger impression is really bad, so please don't pay attention to it. Please don't. Now these people, I want them to have a nice large backyard, which means we're gonna like keep, what is it, three? Let's have like four in the middle. So we can like create their own backyards. Like we can do a bit of detail working on that. I think that's three. That means it's four. Like so. And then grab you again and you go right there. I think that is... that is connected up. You go there, and there, and there. So these people will have a larger backyard than these guys. These houses are a bit less expensive than these ones in here. And garbage is an issue. Now, that was probably one of the next things I would have done, or will do in these episodes. I'm gonna make a garbage incineration island or something, or at least like a place where a ton of garbage will be incinerated, and just so it wouldn't like be in everything. Like there's a garbage incinerated there and there and for every area. I just want a nice central place where all the garbage trucks go to separate directions and pick up the trash and all. And we might do even like a landfill area or a dump if we have the resources for that. I still got a detail. Finish detailing this episode, and I know I always say I will, but you know, it never really... I don't play this game except for when I'm recording, so I say I'm gonna fix that off screen, and then it just never happens because I don't play the game off screen. I don't have time for it, and when I do play the game, I want to record for you guys. So it's always dilemmas in this first world problems thing. Now, still no new houses in this area, which kind of sucks. I would like people to upgrade. Oh, you're pissed. You know what? We're gonna just go for... death will be upon us. There's a church with a graveyard. I don't want a graveyard. So this is a nice hospital. That's a modern hospital. I think we can do a bit of modern hospital here. That is a perfect location. That is the perfect location for a hospital. Looks like a school, but it isn't. And you can play basketball on like the top floor. So we got a Sophia Hospital right here. That means the people will be happy soon. And then let's see if we can have like a police. What's this? This is the fire department. Like, have the fire department here. It looks like a bus depot. So that's two in one. Cool. That will work. We're gonna have a nice little park in the back of the hospital. So the people from there and there can take a walk and sit there. And whatever. Do things. I don't know. Now these are all complaining about garbage. So I think it's time to do a temporary solution to these problems. That is the garbage incineration plants. Let's do just two there or something, and then we'll see what happens. So water there, and have the power go like here, across the road. So that's connected up, and they will pick up the garbage in this area, which will work very nicely. Now, there's only one problem I have in this, well, there's more than one problem, but this is a very annoying one, and it's this. And that is the camera cinematic mode mod. And you cannot get that menu out of the way, which leaves me with a couple issues. Usually, when I took thumbnails for this game, I would use this cinematic mode camera and take a nice thumbnail like this of the area. There was nothing I would have cut out, because this would be the thumbnail, and I would lay my thumbnail design over this and change a couple things, you know, change the color a bit. But now I can't use it anymore, so I firstly have to use this one, which leaves me with that brush right there on the left of the screen. Now there's a picnic table in there. You know, this is quite annoying, actually. So that means I'm gonna have to cut out, like, probably this part is the only thing I'm able to use, and then when this message go away. So that's quite annoying. So if the mod, he doesn't listen. There was a ton of comments on his mod. Get that menu out of the way. Give us a button where we can like hide the UI or something. No updates. So issues. I don't know if I'm gonna keep the mod in. I really have no idea if I am gonna keep it in. But if I ever wanna make cinematic shots, which I'm probably, you know what? Mark my words, we're gonna do a cinematic episode in episode 25. We're gonna do cinematic shots of, you know, the areas we have built, like the neighborhood, the downtown. This is completely destroyed, so this is gonna be deleted by episode 25. You know, I wanna mark episode 25 as an update video, and I wanna make everything nice and perfect and cool and make it work. So I gotta detail all these areas to make the cinematics look cool, and that's something I gotta focus on soon. So that's something to watch out for you guys. Anyways, I'm rambling about again. It's 50 minutes episode, so I'm gonna quit the recording for now, and I think I'm gonna go right back at it and gonna do a back-to-back recording, because I have time today, which is amazing. Or I am going to do detail working on different places and fixing stuff. I don't know what's gonna happen yet. I still gotta get my head around it. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like on it. And if you did not, please leave a like on it. I hope to see you in the next one, of course. And yeah, have a good day. Like usual, happy whatever day it is. Probably Wednesday or something. Happy day. And I'll see you in the next one. I hope you enjoyed. Take care, guys. You're awesome. And bye-bye.